Okay, so let's continue. Okay, so just or I want to say the last thing we went ahead and labeled is variety. Again, just choose an area in your composition again that we're creating together where you find or feel you used some variety. Go ahead and just label that, and then we're going to continue. Okay, so what I want to do now is just label pretty much, just go over space. Like what we've created here is the illusion of space. One point perspective. Perspective in general is a great way to go ahead and create that illusion. So the way that I want you to go ahead and label this is we're going to, because especially as we start drawing from observation, I'm such a big, as your art teacher, you're going to see, I'm always going to ask you to kind of look at the negative shape of the things that you're drawing, because sometimes it's just easier to draw the negative shape around something, than sometimes it is to actually draw the thing, and what I'm saying is, like, look, I have a pair of scissors and we're gonna draw scissors as a class. So as far as when we start drawing and it's time for you to draw the pair of scissors that you decide on, I a lot of times will ask you, take a look at the negative space. See the negative space that has nothing in there? Sometimes it's easier to draw that than the actual thing itself. So what I want to do in this little composition is label. And when I say negative space are the things that don't, of course, negative space are the areas where there's nothing. So I want you to choose an area that has nothing. Like, so for example, here, and you're going to go ahead and just write, this is an example of negative space. And negative space, again, get used to it. I'm going to say negative space a lot. I really am, especially when we're drawing from observation. Okay, and then of course, the areas that take up space, those are what we call our positive space. So anywhere, again, it's going to be up to you where you want to put it. All right, if you're following me, that's fine. Just make sure you write positive space. Okay, so here's an example of positive space, and here's an example of negative space. So we have that. Now, color. Color is the one for this year. Usually, again, I told you that when we do it as a class, in class, there are color pencils from day one. After we're done with the drawing here and all the perspective and the erasing and stuff, at this point, we're gonna get to that point where I would usually say, all right, jump in with the color. All right, so there are a couple of things. Again, this is looking like it's probably going to be my center of interest, but again, I'm holding off, and you're going to see why in the end why I'm holding off on doing that. And before we just begin in sort of getting into sort of, I guess you can say, the shading in and the adding texture and the value, before we start getting into that creative piece of our composition, we're going to just label one more thing. And I told you how I was trying, or I'm creating this movement, that's happening this way. All right, I also can, again, put in maybe I'll put another circle here and another circle again, not a full circle, just something kind of peeking back there. Okay, and I'm trying to create that movement. So there's kind of like a movement happening this way. And I think I want to put one more circle in here like this. I'll do that. And there's a movement that's happening. So before we start getting into sort of, the truly creative part of this, let's just go ahead and put in and give and label movement. So I do, I have a movement that's happening here. And again, because a lot of this is being labeled, and it's okay, I'm gonna do like a line because my movement is kind of going like this towards my center of interest. So I'm gonna go ahead and write movement. And oh, or you could put rhythm. I'm sorry, we should put the two. Movement, rhythm, and that's marked off. All right, and now again, our ultimate goal of all the principles of art design, we want this thing in the end to have unity. All right, so now what we're gonna do is start getting into the creative end or creative piece of this, and that's sort of adding color. Again, if you wanna go with color in this, everything we're gonna do from this point on, feel free to jump in with the color. So now we're gonna jump back to our list. There are, again, we did a composition on line, shape, and form, and then we still have value, texture, and space. So texture and space, value is we're gonna leave that element for the last. Remember I told you with color is one that we're not going to worry about. Color, we're going to eventually get to it, and of course we all know what color is, And I know even in this, some of you are going to use it. So if you add color, then all you need to do is just check that off. As soon as you add any little bit of color, I want you to go ahead and just check that off. But as far as, you know, the compositions, you know, for our value composition, you're going to see we're actually going to sort of create, and I'm going to show you now, something like this. You know, I have these dittos that I always hand out, but we're going to, and you'll see, you know, it's going to be a pretty easy composition because we're going to go ahead and create value scales. You know, if you took Basic Studio and my Basic Studio kids out here, you know, this is important. You want to make sure, you know, if we're talking about value, that you understand, you know, this is a shading chart. Okay. And when we do this as a class, we're going to create a little value scale. And in our first square, we're going to try to get it as dark as we can. Right. And then we're going to go ahead and start getting lighter and lighter and lighter to the light of the page. When we get into landscapes, because we are going to be doing landscapes this year, the same thing. You know, if you look out, even if you, you know, take notice now when you're out in nature and you look out into the distance, you'll see that things in the background are very light and faint. And as, of course, it gets closer, everything gets a little bit darker. So we're going to be doing this as a class together. But even for this, for our chart, we're going to go ahead and start shading and giving value to one of these cubes. Now again, when I say go ahead and finish it off, you can do whatever you want to do with it and you decide. But what I want to show you and as a class is, again, you know, what happens here. So when we are shading these little boxes here, what you'll notice is if I turn it on the side here, okay, you're going to see, and I'm going to lay this down here, you know, so that you can see it. This is our value scale. You know, if you had me for studio, you know what I tell you. When we draw this from observation, because that's how we start in studio, you can see that this tone here, you want to find the tone that it matches on your value scale, and you're going to shade it in. And the same thing here. For here, you can see which tone it would be. And then, of course, here would be super light. It would be somewhere over here. So now if I go ahead and I, you know, just put this to the side here, and I want you to decide which square you're going to shade. Okay, I think I'm going to shade number 3. All right, so if I hold it there, you can see, if I look at my value scale, right, you could see how this side here is going to be pretty dark. Okay, and then of course this not so much. So what I'm going to ask you to do is to choose one side to go ahead and a shade darker than the other, because you can see what's happening in the actual, you know, in actuality. Again, if you guys were all in here, you'd all have your cube and it would be very easy to see. I'm doing the video too, you know, for you, so that way, you know, it will, you know, it'll just make it easier because you're actually seeing what's happening and what would have been happening in front of you. All right, so then we have this. You know, again, if you have a tissue, great. I did give out tortillion stomps, you know, the shading tools, but I don't want you to have to worry so much about this. Only because you're going to see, even in the value scale, I'm going to tell you, please don't use your tortillion stump. Instead, wait for it. Wait until we get to the actual projects. Use a tissue, okay? So a tissue works great, or even your finger. You know, when we get to the pastel drawing, again, to save time, I didn't bring a tissue near me, so I don't want to waste time to go run. But you can see that I did it with my finger, okay? So here, we went ahead and we added value. So let's go ahead and, you know, go ahead and label that and mark that one off. So value is done. And here we just added a little bit of value to this, to box number 3. Again, you decide which one you want to do. If you want to do this one, because in the video you can clearly see what I'm talking about, how you need to give each side of the square, you know, a tone of value. All right. And then again, you can also, you can easily, if you wanted to, go ahead and shade in some of these, but then of course leave some so that you do have that mixture of shapes and forms. But you could do the same thing here. That's an option for you when I let you go to finish these off. Okay. So we have value. Now texture. Texture, if you had me for studio, and again, I'm going to be going bouncing back and forth through the presentation in class. Here are some examples of squares, you know, with a little, again, a little bit of, or little examples of texture. All right. I know in my studio classes, we do many projects actually where we're exploring textures. Okay. So again, because I want to make sure that we hit all our elements before we jump into our principles. So what I'm going to say is, let's take this little box here. This is probably the easiest one to do. And I think I'm going to turn it this way so you guys can see. Maybe I'll do box number 5. Okay. And pretty much to create this, and if you took studio and you did scratch board, or if you did something like that, then you know, all right, all you need to do is use line. You could create line, use line to create the illusion of hair or texture. You're going to have this example there for you. So in your, you know, in the classroom and however, I'm going to ask you to add a little bit of texture. I give this ditto off here. So that way, again, I want you to get creative with it. I'm just putting a little bit of, line here again, because I don't want this video to be too long. So, but you can go ahead and continue and add as much texture as you want. And then here, what we're going to do is just, of course, label texture. Okay, so now, other than color, if you decide to go with color to make this not complicated and make this video not too long, color is the only one that I'm going to say is optional this year, because I know not all of you have color pencils. So if you want to add color, that's great. Now we can go ahead and jump into our principles of design. Okay, so I'm going to stop here for a minute.